On one of my many journeys to these beautiful stones at Stonehenge, England, in the Salisbury Plain, I almost always have a harp. And on this one occasion, we set the harp in the center of the stones, and it was a summer solstice, and I put a microphone inside the harp. And the wind coming off the Salisbury Plains is often quite strong, and it created an Aeolian harp, wind harp effect in the harp, and that's what you'll hear now. We made a full circuit around the outer stones, which took quite some time. Everyone was repeating the mantra, Om Ahum Vajra Guru Padma Siddhi Hum, over and over internally, as this harmonic field was building around the circle. And as I came toward one of the guards, I was a little concerned because he stopped me, and I thought I was in trouble creating too much noise with the harp. And he said, "What is that sound?" And I explained to him, it's a natural effect of the wind blowing through the strings. They call it an Aeolian harp. And actually, it was written in the Songs of Solomon in the Bible that as the wind moves through the lyre, making the strings to speak, so that the spirit speaks throughout my body, causing me to speak with love. So this is an ancient kind of phenomenon, and many people have discovered it. And the important thing here is that the guard said, "I was totally enchanted by the sound. Don't put your harp down. I love this sound because it's very similar to what I and the other guards have heard late at night when we're guarding the stones, and it seems to be emanating from the stones themselves." And this I found extraordinary, because if this is true and the stones are humming during the night, and a normal Englishman guard could hear this, then it moves from the inaudible realm into the audible. And perhaps they were in an altered state because they're alone at night. They have nothing else to do but walk around the stones, and the stones are interacting with them, creating an interspecies sort of effect, creating perhaps an altered state from what they're sensing. And the brain then is attuned, dropping into an altered state, theta, sometimes even delta. When we're chanting, this occurs. We've tested this in the acoustic laboratories in the University of Washington in Seattle. Immediately when chanting, a brain state will drop down into theta and sometimes delta, and the brain waves will come into coherence and become balanced between theta and alpha. Anyway, this is the state that shamans enter into, healers, people that are attuned to various subtle frequencies. And so this experience in the stones didn't stop there. We finished our circumambulation, our chanting, and we stood at one side of the stones, just observing and giving thanks. And numerous people in our group, well, I think we had 15 people, observed the stones glowing blue. Now they call them the blue stones. They were brought in from the Preseli Mountains in southern Wales. How they got them there, we don't know. But is it possible that they used sound, specific types of sound that were considered more harmonic and sacred, to soften the stones, perhaps giving an anti-gravity effect? Now, a lot of people talk about, oh, they move the stones through levitation. Well, I don't believe it. You know, I'm a bit of a skeptic. But current research is finding that the particles, the very small nanoparticles, phonons, we have photons, of course, we've all heard of the small light particles. Phonons are caused by acoustical waves and acoustical effects. Phonons are particles that have an anti-gravity quality. So, is it possible that the stones were becoming lighter and actually light was experienced around them by the participants? Was that from their brain state changing, or the stones, or perhaps both?